When I think about dogs with Lyme disease, I think of two scenarios. The first is a dog that comes in that's sick. If a dog comes in with signs of lameness and fever and tests positive for Lyme disease, it's pretty straightforward to me. He gets a course of treatment. Now, Lyme disease in humans is a terrible problem. It can be very difficult to treat. But in dogs, a simple course of antibiotics is curative. A 3 to 4 week course fixes the dogs, and there's no long-term recurring problems. So that's pretty straightforward and easy. There is, however, another situation we get into, which is where a dog comes in for a routine examination, has a blood test, and the test returns that the dog is positive or has been exposed to the Lyme organism. What do we do in that situation? There are two schools of thought. One is to treat the dog in the idea that we will prevent him from becoming ill in the future, and that's reasonable. The other scenario is where we say, well, it's kind of an overuse of antibiotics, so we'll just watch and see how the dog does. And to be honest, that's also reasonable. The reason I say that is, for example, in Lyme, Connecticut, when tested, over 90% of the dogs will test positive for exposure to Lyme disease. Yet when followed over time, less than 3% will ever show signs of illness. So in our situation, when a dog tests positive but has no clinical signs of illness, the option of whether to treat or not is probably best made between you and your veterinarian.